Hey guys, recently a free pump video was uploaded by King Homemade, who has more than a million followers. The concept that he showed in the video was to mechanically couple a 220 volts generator to an induction pump, and after that the wires of both the machines will also be connected together. So today in this video we are going to find out if this technique actually works or not, and if it does work, then for how long. So make sure to watch the entire video before leaving comments. Now, I'm not going to make a generator since I already have one. It is a 220 volts generator. So let me show you how it performs. This is a 220 volts 100 watts bulb, which is going to act as load here. Next, I will be using my drill machine to test it. That's the plug of the drill machine. And we are ready to go. Also, I've got this new drill bit set, so don't forget to watch its full testing at the end of this video. So guys, now that you have watched the video in full, it is time to reveal the secrets behind it. So the concept behind the working of a generator is that when it gets loaded, like electrically loaded, in that case it gets really tight, because of which it is very difficult to turn it. And for this reason, this free pump concept is total fake, since there is a hidden wire going to the pump and it cannot be seen in the video. Now, if you know where the wire is going, let me know in the comment section. Anyways, there is this question that arises now. How come when we connect the supply to the pump, it does not start on its own? Now, the answer for it is that I have disconnected one of the wires of the capacitor that is responsible for starting this type of induction motor, because of which, once the capacitor has been disconnected, the water pump cannot start anymore on its own. So it needs a physical pressure, and that is the only thing that I gave it with the help of rope rotation and sometimes with my hands. It was really easy. It looked like I was actually giving it some kind of kinetic energy to incite a perpetual motion mechanism. So now comes the part on how King Homemade actually did that. So in his video, he took a stool, a wooden stool, and then kept the stool with generator and water pump installed on it. This entire thing was kept on a cemented bridge. Now, my theory says that he actually planted two metal rods while building that bridge, and he powered those rods, and the positioning of those rods was exactly the same as that of the legs of the table. So when the table was kept on those exact rods, the circuit completed and the induction motor received its power. And that is how he did that. A scam fake video. Hey, I've got these new cobalt drill bits. They are 99 in total. You can see so many different sizes, from some really thin bits to these 10 mm thick ones. And here you can see how sharp they look. Seems like they are great quality, but we can be sure only after putting them to actual test. So here I'm going to choose this 4 mm bit, and this single drill bit is going to represent the fate of this entire set. So let's do some drilling. And note, if you also want to buy this set, link will be provided in the description below. So here I'm going to use this thick metal piece, and I've already made the center punch, you can see. So let's drill a hole with this 4 mm bit. You saw how easily it did that. Now let's try an even stronger metal piece. It's a piece from an old motor housing. So I've already made the center punch on it. Now it's time to put some oil and do the test. Well, that was excellent. And considering these tests, I'm going to give it 5 out of 5 stars, which means this set is going to be my new favorite. So guys, that's all for today's video. Thank you for watching it. Goodbye.